dear student, now we studied about automatic generation control in interconnected power system. First we studied the introduction about automatic generation control in integrated power system. The previous lecture video we studied about the automatic generation control, automatic voltage reactor, that means reactor AVR, and then automatic load frequency controller ALFC, everything studied comes under automatic generation control. Now automatic generation control in the interconnected power system only. Okay, when we have interconnected power system, that is more than one power systems are interconnected through die lines only, the automatic generation control has to take into account the die line flow only. A group of generators coupled closely will swing together and may be replaced by a single equivalent generator. The generator turbines also, that means, tend to have a same response characteristics. Such generators are said to be a coherent, and the system is called the control area. This is the definition of the control area. If when different control areas are connected, the objectives of the automatic generation control are, the first one is hold the system frequency close to the nominal value of 50 Hz. Second one is to maintain a correct value of power interchange between control areas. Third one, maintain generation of each unit at the most economic value only. So the automatic generation control of a multi-area system can be studied by first considering a two-area system only, which is studied about in the next section only. So the first one is the die line control with the primary speed control only comes under this topic. We studied about the change of load in area 1, change of load in area 2, and change of load in both areas only. First, that means you have to study P12. P12 means the power interchange from area 1 to area 2. That is equal to E1 E2 divided by X12 into sine delta 1 minus sine delta 2 only. So, where the X12 is equal to X1 plus X die plus X2 only. So, the equation 1 can be linearized about on a initial operating point. So, therefore, the del 1 is equal to del 1 0 and del 2 is equal to del 2 0 only. So, therefore, the del P12 is equal to E1 E2 divided by X12 cos del 1 0 minus del 2 0 into del F12 only. Therefore, the del F2 is nothing but del F1 minus del F2. Let T equal to E1 E2 divided by X12 into cos del 10 minus del 20, that is equal to maximum power P max into cos del 10 minus del 20, where capital T is called the synchronizing torque coefficient, that means which is designated as P delta. So, substituting equation 4 into the equation 2, we get del P12 is equal to T into del delta 1 minus del delta 2. So, the triangle that delta is the change, represents change in the del 1 is the torque angle or the power angle only. Now, we see the block diagram of the two area system. Okay, we see the two area system, area 1, area 2. So the power interchanged from 1 to 2, that's why P12, I indicate the arrow mark in between die is the X die is the reactance of that die only. So then next, then you see the diagram, that is the figure B. So for the figure A represents two area system, the figure B is the electrical equivalent circuit of the two area system only. So the first one, that the area is equal to E1, the angle is del 1, the power angle del 1, X1 that reactance, after that the die reactance, then area 2 is the E2 angle of delta 2, and then the respective reactance of area 2 is the X2 only. So now you can come to, that means the two area system with primary loop only. This is the block diagram. Now this is only we have to study about it. So in this case and all, so del P reference 1 of S, then that is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus S into TG1, that is the governor block. So the del P reference, that is nothing but the speed changer block only, that is summation, the droop is 1 by R1 for the area 1. So then generator, that is the governor block, 1 divided by 1 plus S into TG1 is the governor model. The output is the del PV of 1, that is the valve output. Then 1 divided by 1 plus S into TR, that is the turbine. TR represents for turbine, G for that is the governor only. So that is the first generator model, that is the governor model, then next turbine model. And then the output of the turbine is del PM, that is mechanical power only. So here del PL1 is nothing but the load, that is okay. So change in the load only. So next power system model, 1 divided by 2H of 1 S plus D1 only, the output is del omega 1 of S only. So in between you can join this A, similarly you can draw the area 2 also, you can combine it together and all, we can put the capital T only. So the capital T what we studied here and all, that means capital T and all is called the synchronizing torque coefficient only. So therefore in this case and all, the power transferred from area 1 to, so therefore the del P 1 2 is the that is the positive only. Okay, if suppose the power transferred from 2 to 1 means that is minus of del P 1 2 only. So therefore that block 1 that is the 1 divided, that is the del, here we this equation is there, now you can go to the equation that is del of P1 of 2 equal to T into del del 1 minus del 2, that block equation only here we can draw. You see first the top one is area 1, bottom is the area 2, in between you can connect it 1 by S and all, both del 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 1 plus minus del 2, then T is there. So this is the del P1 of 2 is equal to T into del del 1 minus del del 2 only. So this diagram is nothing but the two area system with primary loop only. Here comes under this topic, that means three subdivision is there. Now first one, I changed the load in the area 1. If the load changes in area 1, what happens? The del omega is equal to del omega 1 is equal to del omega 2 only. That means when the system has reached a steady state, both area will have the same steady state frequency deviation if we change the load in area 1. Okay, that means del F equal to del F1 is equal to del F2 only. Okay, so therefore and all, that means both del F and del omega are same. Okay, so now we assume that the mechanical power are constant, the die line and the rotating masses exhibiting damped oscillation called the synchronizing oscillations only. Now for area 1 we write down the equation del PM1 minus del P12 minus del PL1 is equal to del omega D1 only. So then del PM2 is similarly we have to write, that means equation that is the area 2 only, del PM2 plus del P12 is equal to del omega D2 only. So the del P of del PM1 is equal to minus of del omega divided by R1, del PM2 is equal to minus of del omega divided by R2 only. Okay, so the substituting equation 9 and 10 in the equation 7, we get minus del P12 is equal to minus del P12 minus del PL1 is equal to del omega into 1 by R1 plus D1. Therefore, the del P12 is equal to del omega into 1 by R2 plus D2 only. So that is del omega is equal to del P12, that means that is minus del PL1 divided by 1 plus R1 plus 1 plus R2 into 1 plus plus d1 plus d2 only. So therefore del p12 is equal to del omega into 1 by r2 plus d2, that is equal to minus del pl1 into 1 by r2 plus, that means d2 divided by 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 plus d1 plus d2 only. Okay, in the next video we studied about if the load changes in the area too. So thank you student for watching this video.